The saint whom I mentioned this day, St. Francis, had a real pithy and magnificent insight about humility. He said, where humility is present, annoyance is absent. Isn't that a great thing to possess, huh? The absence of annoyance in our life. You see, one of the reasons humility is so elusive, and it is in our day and age, is that its opposite, pride, is so powerful in this world, so seductive. Now, humility, however, is part and parcel with our calling to follow Christ. We, as Christians, are called to be humble. St. Paul says in the epistle this day, walk worthy of the vocation with all lowliness and meekness, that is to say, in humility. And Jesus speaks of humility this day also in the gospel narrative. At the beginning, we hear Jesus healing a man with dropsy. And he healed him on the Sabbath in the house of a Pharisee. Isn't that something? That's a powerful call that he did, an action, to the simplicity and sanctity of good works, that stuff we prayed for this day, over and above merely observing the law, no matter what. That's what we're called to do. And he spoke to the least humble, the powerful prigs, those nincompoops that we call the Pharisees. They thought they knew everything, and they knew not. He said, when you are invited to a marriage feast, don't sit down in the highest seat, lest your host come and say to you, give this man place, and you begin with shame to take the lowest place. That'd be embarrassing, wouldn't it? Hey, you're in this man's seat, go somewhere else. It'd be kind of like going to a football game or whatever and sitting in one of the seats you know it's not your place to be. And you have to be called out and, you know, you entail behind your back and, ooh, I got caught. And then you go in your own place. Well, that's essentially what was going on in the marriage feast parable. Rather, Jesus says, don't do that. He said, rather, sit in the lowest place that when your host comes, he can say, friend, go up higher. He said, whoever exalts himself, lifts himself up, shall be abased, put down. He that humbleth himself shall be exalted, lifted up. The desire for status is deep-seated, once again, dark, and a never-ending task. And this is really the important part, it is simply wrong. A lesson in humility is what we are called to hear and respond to. Kind of like the humility we see in children. Do you remember what Jesus said about children? He said, whosoever humbles himself as a little child, the same is the greatest in the kingdom of heaven. Mm-hmm. Yeah, we know that, don't we? You watch little kids, they're happy, they play. That's why we praise kids, because, you know, they start out in life knowing they need their parents' help in order to make it in life. They're not self-sufficient. They just are happy to be alive and play and smile, hang around grandpa and grandma. Kids have a tendency, however, to grow up. And oftentimes they mimic grown-ups because, you know, how do we learn? We learn from other people what they say, what they do, and how they act. And so the children mimic grown-ups, and slowly but surely, more often than not, self-absorption enters in rather than acquiring this virtue that we're called to embrace, humility. The way of the world is pride. Listen, you want to get the best seat. Climb that ladder. It doesn't matter how many people you have to step over or step on. Get to the top. That's the way of the world. Self-exaltation. And yet, we look to Jesus. We follow him who taught and lived humility. You know this magnificent act that we thank God for every time we have a Mass, you know, the Incarnation. The Incarnation is the definitive proclamation of humility. God, always has been, always will be. God became one of us in the person of Jesus Christ, became flesh and blood. Jesus, who humbled himself, therefore God humbled himself, and became obedient unto death, even the death of the cross. And so from the beginning, the womb, to the end, the tomb, Jesus humbled himself. As followers of Jesus, God in the flesh, we're called to the same. It's a simple thing. It only means allowing our will to be totally subject to the will of God, just as Jesus was, huh? And to become, therefore, God's child again. To have such love and conviction and steadfastness about the faith that we will gladly lose our life, friends, family, fortune, doesn't matter, for the sake of the gospel and for God's greater glory. And so that simple, humble Francis was right. Where humility is present, annoyance is absent. In the end, where is that? Heaven. Friend, go up higher.